Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Today, I will start a new series on decoding martial proverbs. At the same time, I will keep working on the previous video series as well whenever interesting topics come to mind. So, please feel free to send me suggestions on any topics that you are more curious to know about. The reason behind this new series is very simple. A proverb is a simple and concrete quote that was created and used traditionally to express a specific meaning in a memorizable and speakable way. Very often, a proverb becomes so well known that it becomes synonymous with the style itself. However, the metaphorical and formulaic language of most proverbs often causes confusion. Very often, the linguistic format of a proverb can mislead the practitioners from its true intentions of describing a procedural knowledge. Even worse, the real meaning can easily get lost or twisted during their transmissions from one generation to another. This can be a major hindrance to knowledge transfer in the martial art community, since some key cultural elements would be filtered away in translation. I find it would be helpful to many people if I not only translate some of them, but also interpret them in detail. That's the motivation behind this new series. One challenge of this series is that it is hard to organize the content. If you have watched prior videos, you may have noticed that I used a systematic way to organize information. However, when introducing training proverbs, I will need to change the way I organize information. A potential issue is that it may not be as structured as prior formats, but I will do my best to clarify each point, especially to a non-Chinese audience. I may not follow any specific order, but in explaining and correcting each proverb, I will still follow an organized structure. In other words, at the macro level, it may look random, but at the micro level, information will be organized in a fixed structure in order to improve its comprehensibility. The micro level format used will be normally first, origin of the proverb, second, commonly understood explanation, or third, correction if necessary, fourth, my interpretation, and fifth, demonstration if necessary. At the same time, I'd like you all to contribute any proverbs that you think are not clear. This will help me to work on this series in a more targeted way. I would much rather have a dialogue than a monologue. In today's video, I'd like to focus on two important proverbs. First, 4两拨千斤, or 4 ounces deflect 1,000 pounds. Second, 气沉丹田, or energy sinks to the 丹田. So, let's talk about the first proverb. 4两拨千斤, or 4 ounces deflect the 1,000 pounds. To many people in the Chinese martial art community, this proverb is very well known, especially to Tai Chi practitioners. It is the must-know proverb. However, this proverb can be very misleading, and in my opinion, this is one of the main reasons why most Tai Chi practitioners perform Tai Chi like a dance. I will explain the details now. First, origin of the proverb. This proverb was first used in Chinese fortune telling. In fortune telling, the proverb implied that by adapting small changes, one could change their destiny. Later on, martial artists adopted this term to express a martial practice principle. In the context of martial arts, this proverb was first found in Wu Yuxiang and Li Yu's book, Lian Rang Tang Tai Chi Quan Pu, or Tai Chi Document of Lian Rang Tang. Wu Yuxiang, the founder of Wu Hao style Tai Chi, and one of his most important Tai Chi scholars in history, published this book with his nephew, Li Yu. This book included a Tai Chi article written by Wang Zongyue, one of the earliest Tai Chi scholars. Wang Zongyue's article first mentioned the quote, Si Liang Bo Qian Jin, or 4 ounces deflect 1,000 pounds. Since then, this quote became popular in the Tai Chi community. Later on, many other Chinese styles started using this proverb to express the advantage of their training. Even a Shaolin document named Shaolin Quan Qu Bi Ge Jue even mentioned this the same proverb. For more detailed information, please watch my Tai Chi introduction video. Second, commonly understood explanation. The most common explanation of this term, Si Liang Bo Qian Jin, is the literal translation itself. 4 ounces deflect 1,000 pounds. It gives you the impression that Tai Chi is such a wonderful style that you can use a little bit of force to counter a great force. Sounds too good to be true. However, it is really that investigate. All of us understand that in order to ensure that a martial technique works, some specific criteria must be met, or else the technique would be ineffective in application. Now, if we assume that the 4 ounces can deflect 1,000 pounds, is that statement true always or only under specific conditions? Let me reiterate. There's no universal technique that will use a very small force to generate a great effect, at least to my understanding. If anyone claims that such a technique exists, they are most likely a scam artist, not a martial artist. So, what are the external and the internal factors that can generate the result of Si Liang Bo Qian Jin? Unfortunately, Wang Zongyue did not explain it at all. But how about other people? Well, Li Yu, the author of that Tai Chi book, nephew of Wu Yuxiang, explained this term in his document, saying that if you want to have the effect of 4 ounces can deflect 1,000 pounds, you have to know how to 眼进落空, or lead the attacking force forward and then let the attacking force fall into emptiness. To have 眼进落空, and according to his writing, you need to have 得机得势, or timing and situational awareness. Check out my Tai Chi introduction video for an explanation of 眼进落空. Now we can see that Si Liang Bo Qian Jin is not a universal technique. More specifically, it is a technique that uses the technique of 眼进落空. 4 ounces can deflect 1,000 pounds is the result of applying leading the attacking force forward and then let the attacking force fall into empty. Third, correction of this proverb. There are two mistakes caused by misunderstanding of this proverb. Mistake 1. 4 ounces deflect 1,000 pounds is supposed to be an effect of applying a specific technique or practical tactics. But unfortunately, it has been generalized and promoted as a Tai Chi principle. Again, it is not a Tai Chi principle. It is the result of applying specific techniques under specific circumstances. Mistake 2. In my opinion, it is the real problem which has created a lot of misperceptions in martial art practice. Think about it. If someone can have a technique that can defeat a huge force by just applying a little force, that would be great. So, if that would be the case, then you won't need to practice too much. But instead, you would just need to figure out the best technique with which you would be able to defeat a strong person. More interestingly, there is the theoretical support for such a dream, and Si Liang Bo Qian Jin is one of them. Now, I have to say that is totally wrong. Let me elaborate. First, let me introduce the term Gong Li or power. This term consists of two Chinese characters. One is Gong and the other one is Li. So, what is Gong? Gong is any skill achieved through practice. Then, what is Li? Li is force. However, unfortunately, the English translation today has been reduced to just one word, power. And even more unfortunately, that is the Chinese understanding today as well. I think this translation omits a lot of context. Originally, this term meant skill and force, or two separated concepts put together to express an idea of martial ability. But somehow it has lost its complete meanings. Now, let's come back to the Si Liang Bo Qian Jin proverb. So, what does Si Liang Bo Qian Jin? So, what does Si Liang or 4 ounces mean here? Well, it expresses a skill. Then, what does Qian Jin or 1,000 pounds mean here? Actually, it indicates force. So, this proverb put two separated concepts, including skill and force, together. Very similar to comparing apples to orange. No wonder it is confusing. Therefore, to really understand this proverb well, we have to look at another version of it which is well known to some experts but not very popular in the community. This version says, 练就千斤力，只用四两功, which translates to have 1,000 pounds of force through practice but only use 4 ounces worth of skills. This totally changed the meaning of that proverb. It emphasized that in order to use 4 ounces of skill in application, you first have to practice enough so that you possess a 1,000 pounds of force. Now, this approach does not sound appealing or marketable to the general public. But this is the right approach in practice. I believe that skill alone would not work without a necessary level of force or strength. Those who only pursue skill without making enough effort to gain the necessary force or strength will only face disappointment whenever they need to test out their skills. 4. Now, let me tell you my interpretation of this proverb. So, 4 ounces can defeat 1,000 pounds should be explained differently from now on. Of course, you can improve your skill, but at the same time, please do not neglect the importance of strength or force training. There's no magic in martial application. You may wonder how some old masters can defeat a strong person without using muscular force. Well, of course, at a high level, skill can play a major role in a specific situation. I emphasize the word specific in order to not generalize it. If you are not that old or before you reach a high level in skill, you have to focus on both force and skill training simultaneously. At least, based on my personal experience, all of the old masters, including my own teachers, worked very hard in developing force and strength besides skill development. I have yet to see a high-level practitioner who has focused only on skill without sufficient physical training. Therefore, I hope you will not misunderstand the proverb 四两拨千斤 from now on. Again, it may look less appealing in concept, but it is the truth. Now, let's move on to the second proverb, 气沉丹田. This proverb was suggested by Mr. Thomas Hodacek. Sorry if I'm butchering your last name. Mr. Thomas is a Tai Chi and Qigong teacher from Vienna, Austria. He left a question on my YouTube channel when I asked the community to suggestions on martial proverbs. It is great that he knew the 4 proverbs because most people only know half of it. His question is about how to explain the proverb. The spirit reaches the top of the head and the qi sinks to the dantian. Now, let me explain it. Like I said in the beginning of the video, one of the reasons for misunderstanding some proverbs is caused by the format of the proverb. Sometimes, people may only remember part of the proverb. For example, if there are 2 sentences in a proverb, one of them may get lost during transmission of the knowledge. For example, everyone in the Chinese martial art community understands the importance of 气沉丹田, or sink the energy to the lower dantian. But not many people remember the other part of the proverb, 神意灌顶, or the spirit reaches the top of the head. So, I'd like to explain this proverb in this video. Let's talk about 气沉丹田, or sink the energy to dantian. Actually, this term 气沉丹田 can be found in many other Chinese arts and practice such as singing, meditation, qigong, and martial arts. I have to say it seems that Chinese people are obsessed with the dantian. For example, sometimes when people talk about public speaking, they even emphasize the term 气沉丹田. By the way, in Chinese culture, the sound of your spoken language indicates your health. So, very often, people would try to speak in a certain manner during public speaking by using a specific tone, volume or speed, through 气沉丹田. That's the principle I follow while speaking Mandarin. it likely affects the way I speak English as well. Some people have mentioned that I yell a lot while speaking. Now you know the reason behind it. 气沉丹田 Okay, deal with it. I have already introduced the concept of 丹田 in my prior 丹田 introduction video.I suggest you check it out if you haven't already. Link is in the description. Briefly speaking, the definition of a 丹田, including its location and the function, varies depending on the practice. So, 丹田 in the term 气沉丹田 means the lower 丹田 or the area below the navel.There are quite a few reasons for a martial artist to focus on 气沉丹田. First, lower the body's center of gravity in order to stabilize the stance. Second, calm the mind down in practice. Third, most importantly, relax the body. Please experiment with this yourself.I'm certain you will find it very difficult, if not impossible, to relax your body and mind without sinking the energy to the lower 丹田. I have to say that sinking the energy to the lower 丹田 is the prerequisite for relaxation, which is an aspect that many people neglect. So,气沉丹田 is one of the key factors of being relaxed no matter what situation, self-defense or preparation for qigong or meditation or anything else in between. Also, it is not that hard to understand the concept and the practice of 气沉丹田, since it is the natural structure and the tendency of a healthy and relaxed body. However, as I mentioned in the beginning of this proverb, that many people do not know the other part of the proverb, which is 神意灌顶, or the spirit reaches the top of the head. Now, let me explain this part in detail.The term 神意灌顶 consists of four characters. Literally translation is that 神 means spirit, 意 means mind, 灌 means push toward, 顶 means the top of the head. I prefer to translate this term to raise the spirit upward. In my prior video on the concept of a stanceI introduced the importance of keeping a correct body structure. You should sink the body by leading from the hip area and keep body straight by extending the top of the head upward. Furthermore, in my Xingyi Building Blocks video, I emphasize that when the body moves forward,then you have to lead the movement by the head. When the body sinks downward, then the hip leads the movements. Actually, it says the same thing as this proverb. Energy raised upward to the top of the head is the key principle of adjusting the body structure. This will let you keep your back straight.Which will make the energy flow smoothly without unnecessary blockage. That is the benefit of raising the energy upward by pushing the head slightly upward. I would like to introduce another important sentence which should be added to the proverb, which is 身正气自沉, or,The energy will naturally sink downward when the body strengthens itself. This sentence emphasized the importance of maintaining correct body structure in terms of its impact on the sinking of energy. So, sinking the energy to the lower dantian requires keeping the body straight naturally, which in turn requires the head to extend upward slightly. In other words, 神意贯顶，气沉丹田，身正气自沉。Oh, the spirit reaches the top of the head, and the qi sinks to the dantian, strengthen the body to naturally sink the qi to the lower dantian. Also, it's worth noting that based on decades of teaching experience, I have realized that since many practitioners do not handle the relationships among different body movement, structure, and the mind correctly,They always have a hard time to practice Fa Jin. Whatever Fa Jin they may be able to produce is not good enough to have a sufficient impact. So far, I have introduced two popular martial proverbs by introducing their origins, popular explanations, correct explanations, and my personal interpretations.You may see how far the popular translation have diverged from the original meaning if you consider factors like history, cultural background, and flaws in the transmission of information from one generation to another. Again, I would remind you that this situation is not limited to outside of China. China itself faces the same situation.There are many factors to blame for this situation, but the most important one is that the true meaning got lost either during transmission or translation of information, which eventually occurs in many other practices as well. Now, let's continue on to demonstration. Since I introduced the second proverb, which is the spirit,reaches the top of the head and the qi sinks to the dantian, making the body straight so that the qi will sink to the lower dantian naturally. I'd like to take Xing Yi Santi Stand as an example to demonstrate this principle. Again, this demonstration is not to teach you the Santi Stand, but instead, it is to explain the body sinking, head extending,and structural adjustment in handling different factors to have a good practice. Also, to understand it better, please watch one prior video that introduced the old master's practice. Especially, please pay attention to the concept of old man form since this demonstration is related to that video. Hello!It's very cold in Montreal today. It's -2, -3 degrees. So let's do it fast a little bit, okay? In practice, the 神意贯顶 and the 气沉丹田, we have to pay attention to strengthen the body, make the body straight. In Santi stance, okay? Instead of just like this, so first of all, sink down the body by sinking the hip. Second, the head extend upward.Then palm extend forward by maintaining the body structure. The upper body can steadily lean forward about 5 to 10 degrees, but sinking from here, head extend, then rotate. By keeping this posture, by following this principle, you'll be able to reach the 气沉丹田神意贯顶 and the body straight.Takeaways. This is the first video in the new series, which will focus on decoding important yet often misunderstood martial proverbs. First, the first proverb I talked about is 四两拨千斤, which translates to 4 ounces deflect 1,000 pounds, is most often wrongly taken at face value.And that leads to the disastrous effects. I prefer another version of this proverb, 练就千斤力，只用四两功, which means to have 1,000 pounds of force through practice, but only use 4 ounces worth of skills. Instead of talking about how important the skill is, I emphasize on the importance of force training. Remember, skill alone without force training is not sufficient in self-defense. Second, the second proverb I talked about is 气沉丹田, which translates to sink the energy to the lower 丹田. But I emphasize more on 神意灌顶, which translates to the spirit reaches the top of the head, and 身正气自沉, which translates to strengthen the body to sink the 气 to the lower 丹田. Third,Remember to check out and revisit the demonstration section to see how to adjust your body structure in aligning with the principles of the second proverb. That's in today's video. I hope you will like the new format. Take good care of yourself and enjoy your practice.